So this is the spider that we are going to study today. Okay. In literature, in our literature, you will find that many times it is written as Tarantula lycosa. Okay. That is not the actual spider. There has been a recent research which shows that the actual spider that we have the proving of, the most popular one, that is Tarantula hispanica, is of this spider. The lycosa spider also lives in the European region, so there is what you say, the confusion. Okay, so now having understood this, now let us see what happens when a spider bites a human being. What happens when a spider bites a human being? First is we have to understand, can we go one slide back? First is we have to understand that the spider toxins, mostly and especially of Tarantula, is a neurotoxin. Majority of spider toxins are neurotoxins. Now there are different, kinds of ways a spider attacks. One I told you is the largest spider, that is the Goliath spider, which is also a type of Tarantula spider. This spider, if we look at it, what it does, it has a lot of hairy structure on its body and in its limbs. Okay. Now the moment the Goliath spider feels that there is a threat or a danger to it from something outside, that very moment, its first primary attack is to rub off these hairs. It just rubs the hair very hard and the hair starts to fly around in the air. And once these hair-like tiny particles come and sit on your skin, they produce a allergic reaction. And the allergic reaction is such that at first you will have pain and burning along with irritation and itching. So many times, just because of the pain, burning, irritation, the attacker is pushed away. Sometimes when this does not happen and when the spider bites a human being, the first reaction is primarily at the location. What you will see is immediately after the bite, just a small mosquito bite kind of a injury. This injury tends to just stay like that for 4 days, 5 days, 6 days, 7 days. You don't feel there's much there. You only sense irritation. Slowly, the toxin starts to take its effect. The first effect it will show you is that it will start to produce severe cramps and convulsions. So, there is cramps in the respiratory tract, cramps in the abdomen. So there is asthma, asphyxia, or very severe abdominal cramps. Or there can be convulsions, tetany, those kind of symptoms. Along with it, later on, what can happen is the skin lesion slowly then starts to turn black. And you will observe that there is very severe cellulitis. Then this severe cellulitis later on you will see becomes very severe and there is a very major swelling with complete destruction of tissue inside. It causes a very severe form of necrotizing gangrene where the flesh is literally eaten away. And many times there is a threat of that limb being cut off. That is the effect of the poison. Tarantula in specific, other than these symptoms, can produce fever and chills with profuse sweating. Fever, chills and profuse sweating. one more important area of this cramps and contractions is seen in the heart region. So there is fast pulse or very high blood pressure. You can see symptoms of hypertension, and in the hypertension what you will see is again in this contraction, in this convulsions, another character that you will observe is along with this contractions is violence. You know, you can see the violence in the skin, destruction, gangrene, necrotizing, complete destruction. So in the heart you will see, like I feel that like my aorta will just burst away, it will just tear away, or very severe form of asthma, like status asthmaticus, where you can't breathe at all. Now you, the whole blood supply or the whole air passage is shut off. That's why you will see gangrene or you will see very severe asphyxia. Now, why is tarantula so popular? You know, tarantula is so popular because of one syndrome known as tarantism. Okay, what is tarantism? Tarantism is basically in Europe where this spider is from. What happens there is that when these peasants go into the farm and they are working, they generally see that there is a small mosquito bite, and then slowly the convulsion, cramps, tetany sets in and the body starts to turn black, and you can see that now this person is going to die. The only method by which they could save these people was the village people would then start to play drums. They used to play music for that person. The moment the music started to play, this person would slowly fall. At first his limbs would start to vibrate according to the music rhythms. Slowly the blackness would disappear in those parts. Then slowly the other parts would start to respond, and then the patient as a whole would start to dance, and used to dance for hours together. Literally there have been cases where the patient would dance for 3 to 4 days continuously, and only when he could dance for such a long time that his life could be saved. Otherwise the patient is in threat of dying, because the whole blood supply is cut off, everything just gets completely constricted and tightened up, that nothing can flow, no blood, no air, all is stopped. So the only way you can get out that has been observed is by dancing to music. That is what tarantism is about. There is a uncontrollable impulse to dance. Uncontrollable. Literally for 3 to 4 days you have to dance to save your life. Otherwise you are dead. So for a long time it was considered that the tarantism symptoms are basically caused by Tarantula lycosa. But slowly with the classification it has been found that it is actually Lactodectus, that one, which is responsible for tarantism. Okay, so you may find in our literature that Tarantula hispania is Tarantula lycosa, but it is not actually true. The recent research shows that it is Lactodectus. Now, okay, anything else left? One important symptom along with these contractions is there is very severe sexual excitement, and you will see priapism, like you see, there is compulsive desire to dance. You have to dance to save your life. Like that, the penis just remains erect for hours and days. You can't help it. Priapism.
Mm-hmm.
Now interesting, no? Scorpion is also belongs to arachnids family, very close to spider family. So yeah, possible. So priapism and skin necrosis. Okay, so that those were the toxic symptoms of spiders. Next slide. So this is how Tarantula hispania looks. Okay, next. Toxic in human body, there is pain. In Tarantula, what is characteristic is, one is the tarantism, okay? Second is the sweating. Along with this severe irritation, pain, etc., there will be profuse sweating. Cramps, contractions, chorea, tetany, fast pulse, fever with chills, tarantism, and skin necrosis, gangrene, cellulitis. Okay, next. So this is how the necrosis or the cellulitis looks. You can see black and complete destruction. You see how it is completely eaten away. No, nothing is left. Means literally you will see the muscle, tendons, fascia is eaten away. Finished. Next. You can see here. Eaten away, all the tissue is finished. This, along with this, you can see abscesses, okay? Abscesses, pus formation, very severe forms of infections. Okay, very important remedy for carbuncles, abscesses, all of them.